Kia ora ana, talofa, malo ale, kia ora ana, whakalofa laha atu and warm Pacific greetings from the 2023 Pacific Cup Touch Tournament here. We're coming to you live stream, thank you to the stream shop from Manurewa, Tāmaki Makaurau. We have been here all day yesterday with the youth and today with the Opens and Masters, and we are coming to you with this one, the Open Men's Semi-Finals. And as you see on the screen, we have got coming through on this side, Ngā Tini o Tainui versus Samoa, Open Men's Finals. We are a couple of minutes away from here. This is going to be an epic battle for this one. We have the referees just waiting out in there. We also, as we've become accustomed to on the Pacific Cup, we have Samoa lining up ready for their civitao, and the Tainui team coming out at the same time just to acknowledge in their space. As we see the Tainui teams, we will come through to this and talk a little bit more about the players shortly, but you'll see some of the fan favourites no doubt on there as we just move in to watch this civitao. Awesome. Welcome back after that wonderful civitao from the Samoan Open Men's team. I'm your commentator, Grant Robertson, and I have beside me Rod Walker. Rod, welcome into the hot seat. Here we are, semi-finals Open Men's. What are you expecting to see here?
Yeah, it's a great day in the 09 South side. You know, there's a lot of big games in this game, and obviously we're at this part of the day now. You know, where all the big guns are stepping out and stepping up, so just from that, you know, there's going to be a bit of heat in this game. And I tell you what, it's great to see on the Samoan side here. Rami Kapariki and Neihana Mataafa, they come up from Christchurch, so they're here, you know, representing Samoa. And it's great to see them here. But then, you know, there are a lot of big names in this game today. Tomatoa Rōpati, Samoa. Now, there's the man with the feet. And if Tainui want to, you know, they've got to keep control of him or he will rip up as he usually does. And obviously in the Tainui team, well, it's littered with New Zealand representatives in there. The two Jones boys, they'll be there or thereabouts in terms of their attack and controlling a lot of things. So there's a lot of pressure on the referees here. They've been doing a wonderful job all weekend, both today and yesterday. But I'm looking forward to an exciting game, Grant.
Yes, as we tap off, and shout out to our referees Joseph Green, Roger Neighbours and Ray Cairns getting the triumphant through here as we see Samoa coming through. Dan Putarangi dumping there, checking a little outside link plays. Sweet plays, misses the dive. Oh yes. Quick one to get started. We're going to have to go back to the replay, I think, on this one. Rod, talk me through what you see there.
Yeah, just good sideways movement, just, you know, getting around. And if you don't buckle down on Daniel Putarangi, he's going to go low on you all day long. So, you know, Tainui, we really do need to just stiffen up on their defense there.
Yeah, great to see Daniel back full fitness. He's an absolute weapon in there. He'll be one to stand out with that group as well, whether he's on or off the ball. as we see Tainui now coming down through the lane. Ooh, just checking the defence, I think, there, seeing what was there. Maybe getting a sneaky one, but no, sharp defence in the Samoan middles, nice and tight to start off with. Is that something you will expect to see, Rod, working down the channel?
Yeah, just feeling out at the moment, just trying to find where the space is. And as you know, it's a really good option. Obviously, they took the middle, just try to tighten up the defence a little bit so that on the next play they can go wide. So they certainly are, you know, they're testing early part of the game, so, you know, there's a good options to have.
And just also testing there the strength of the wind, throwing that one that did go out, which does help to set your defensive platform and put Samoa under pressure. Nice work through the middle, the extra plus ball with only one defender flying up there. Samoa looking to get a strong transition off there. Pick and go, split through the middles. Who can he connect to? Nice. Great platform and great reward for Brian Leliafano to dot down for Samoa after setting that platform. Here he is, right on the dump. Scoops straight through both middles. He'll need to fix that one up to Tainui and then gets the fruits.
Yeah, I mentioned that right from the start that Tainui had to keep an eye on Tamato Rōpati, and that's what he can do. That's how dangerous he can be. And unless they close up that hole, he'll keep doing it all day long. Nice little passive play. Good defense by Samoa there. Didn't panic.
Yeah, nice little change up from that 33 peel. Looking at the passive. Samoa get the turnover. Good space getting over to that box. Look for a nice tidy transition here. Eating up the yards. Tainui giving them plenty of space in there to work with at the moment. They're going to roll right back and hold their line. Samoa just shaping back up. Looking to get the rolling call from the referee. So they'll get a full set here. Really starting to test Ngātini's defense. Just seeing what they'll work off right from the start. A little sweep play. Lalau ball. Nothing wrong with that. Often right at the start of the set, Rod, you want to test. Well, for me, I'd certainly look to test as a quickie and a dive in and around that space. Yeah, nothing too expensive.
Early space, just try and move them a little bit. You know, find out an early disconnection if you can. Something you can exploit a little bit later. Certainly, no love lost in this game. There's a fair bit of pressure in those touches.
There is good contact, shall we say, in these early stages. So referees are allowing that to happen. Let's see how that continues. Good consistency is what we'll expect there.
Yeah, and I've got to commend the referees in this game. They're making nice big gap between the teams, allowing them to, you know, to expand and to actually play. Doing a wonderful job at the moment, the referees.
Jones to Barnett, score in the corner. How many times might we say that today?
Yeah, well, it's been said plenty of times in the past. And, you know, a combination that have been together for a long time now. So if you're just on the pick, stood them up, and then, you know, it's a nice little receive and dot down there.
Yeah, just pulling too straight, that defender there, I think, which the one person you don't want to give too much room is E4, so he'll lap that up every day. Samoa right on the attack there, sweep through, bounce back, we've got room. There's the flare right to the winger.
Really testing, just trying to stretch these middles open. Ooh.
Just a hand in there, Shonsi Waho. Otherwise it would have probably gone down. So get a reprieve here, Samoa. They've got all the pressure on the Tainui team at the moment. Get some fresh legs through here. Got a good shape in their defense, Tainui. Looking to open there. Good work.
Takahia Rōpati just organising the troops, just telling them what he wants them to do. Takahia on the sweep, which is his favourite. Nice, in the back, got right behind the gate there. Can he free up? And free up he does.
Clear. Yeah, beautiful play by Samoa. I think what we'll see, we talked about that name, and really the excellent work is they played off that, so the defence of Tainui you saw really shift across to cover, and a pick short side was the perfect option there, and managed to connect into the winger in the corner.
Yeah, Damon Abbey, he has been around for a while, just with a nice little push off there, and you know, got away with it, managed to get himself a half a gap enough to get the ball down.
Awa Morris gets the ball back, releases early right in the corner. Might have found space in there.
Yeah, I think so. Samoa just a little bit guilty there, been just a little bit too tight.
Just waiting to check. Yeah, just confirmation there from the referees. Just checking that the ball was down in there. We don't have the... let's not talk about TMOs and rugby and how long we wait for that one. We get on with things in touch here. So great work by our referees. Straight into it. Samoa back on the halfway line. Have a 3-2.
Absolutely, Grant. The first game is a good game, and we've certainly got plenty of speed in this one. George the Urban Bird just moving through there. Just trying to probe the middles to see what space they can open up.
Finn will lap those ones up all day. Nice though, challenging right to the side. Back through the middle. George and Daniel working together here. Ooh, good cover play, six touch. Nice cover by Tainui. Looking to get their box play, transition on.
Nice transition, nice and clean. Getting to the space, you know, where they really need to attack. Sweep on the outside. Good coverage by Samoa.
Yeah, nice coverage. Stuck in that corner now, fifth and final. Going to see a little bit of oar shape. Might have got him. That's that challenging decision through that middle. Do I shut? Do I not shut? If the comms aren't there, it makes it very, very difficult. Hey, Rob?
Yeah, and I think that was the biggest thing there. I don't think there was a lot of talk there at all. And given it was the last, you know, the key is just to head to man and make sure that you take care of your guys. So they just held off just a little bit too long there.
Yes, the old coach killer on fifth and final. But Samoa back on there. Whoa, just a little drop ball. Now Tini Otaino have come back well here. We're 3-all. 5.5 minutes to go in the first half of this semi-final in the Open Men's at the Pacific Cup.
Samoa just need to get a good stopper in here. You know, they've made a couple of errors. They just need a good stopper here so they can get their transition back again.
Little play, Ifion. Jada Wilson looking for the sweep. Comes back open. Rips long to the air. Well covered though, Samoa. They've got no problems out in that wing space.
Yeah, you know, well, Tony's doing the job. Obviously, the wings, the wind is coming right to left. So, they're obviously worked that out. They're using that as much as they can. And obviously for them, you know, it's a good side of the field to finish a set on.
Good strong contact once again through that orange zone. Ooh, just an overrun.
Yeah, important here for Samoa not to panic. You know, it's still even on the scoreboard. They just need to relax, make sure that they play, you know, error-free touch, and just let everything happen down the right end of the park. So no need to panic at the moment. I think that's the one thing with Tainui. They've got their composure right now, so they're not trying to push it too much. Just need to get through the game.
Yeah, turnover there.
Commentator's killer.
Ooh, yep.
Sorry, timer. I apologise.
It's all right. Just like all the players and the referees and everyone else, we're all human. We get it once in a while. They won't appreciate too many more, but we'll see how we go.
Pearl Jam connection there. George the Urban Burgess and Tomatia Winia. Just playing the middles.
Yep, and I don't mind that. It's just testing that defence, you know. You're not going to get every single one, but what you will is you'll learn what their tendencies are. And if I know anything, George is a pretty quick learner on that space. Tries to break through there and connect. It just doesn't quite get that. So Tini Otainui will look to come nice and strong.
Early transitions are coming on here, so that will put them in good stead. Ooh, a little sneaker down the side. Referee's picked up.
Just a little touch and pass, I think, was the call on that one, Grant.
Yes.
But it's a great option. It's a great option if you can get that little slider just up the sideline there. No one's really expecting it. And a lot of teams, they're getting into this. They're starting to employ it now.
Yes, I like the play. I don't think I want to be the sneaker running down the side. I'm actually just getting into the box. I don't want to run, sprint all the way down. But if you pick the right person, yep, it's a great, becoming far more evident in our game for sure. So we said nice little sweep play, engage those middles, gets the ball away. Referees are happy with that one.
Yeah, Takahua Rōpati on the sweep, and that is his go-to. And a nice early return. Great Hensley from the number six.
Great work. Thomas Staples managing to get that ball away. Put Samoa up by one. 2 minutes to go in this half. Boy, it's going quick. It's definitely quick out there on the field too. So still time, plenty of time here though. Tainui to come back, get the opportunity. Work it away through the middles. Trying to get George up on the high point. Trying to get both middles if they can. Looking to engage that sweep play too. Footwork. Nice.
Didn't even put it only on the cover there. Oh, Finn getting a little bit confused there. Not quite sure what he was doing in that link channel.
Yes,
loss
yes.
of communication, maybe.
Definitely a different two-man play than what we normally see out there on the field. Maybe think, running some shadow and coverage for him.
I think they were actually going for that play that we're not allowed to call, yes. Grant.
Yeah, I did just think about that one too. We're hearing good loud comms defensively on what they want to run there, Tainui. Where they're having to shut or run opens. They defuse that one. They'll look to get the ball to their box side.
Nice and expensive. They obviously understand there's only 40 seconds left to go in this half.
Good, just wanting, lift the tempo now.
Wanting to be the last team to have a crack, make the most of the time that's left. Nice power drive through.
Oh, Tāmaki gets the intercept. Sonny was almost through there, so great work, Samoa, to wrap that one up. Might get a shot at this, about 20 seconds to go. Oh, picked up just a little bit in and around the ruck, so Tainui. Gonna have to go quick. Thought it might have been the old scoop from halfway back in the day. And we come to half-time. Entertaining first half in the Open Men's semi-final. Samoa have it by one, 4-3 over Ngā Tini o Tainui. We will go to the break, let everyone catch a cup of tea, and we'll be back momentarily for the second half.
We can help you get your outdoor space set up for summer.
Portland 4-burner barbecue, $248. Foil tray 20-pack, only $15.80.
Will you find a competitor's lower price on the same stock item? We'll beat it by 15%. Lowest prices are just the beginning.
The Fijian Cup. Supporting grassroots Fiji. With international teams flying in to go up against the best club teams in Fiji. Over 50,000 in prizes for each sport, the Fijian Cup is placing a spotlight on untapped talent. A tournament like no other. I'm the GOAT, the greatest of all time. The greatest of all time. The greatest of all time. Hell yeah. The greatest of all time. Oh, yeah. I'm the GOAT.
All right, we're back live here at Manurewa Pacific Cup Touch. So we just watched both teams just getting through their halfway deliberations. Be interesting to to know how Tainui saw that half and know what change-ups they might need to make. Certainly, I guess, for the Samoan side, I'm picking it's going to be more about just trying to tidy up those little errors that they were making. Not that they've made a few, but you know, this is the level of game where any error can cost you. So I think if they can tidy that up, they'll go a long way to getting there. Tainui just need to get the ball into the hands of, you know, their playing men. Obviously, the two Jones boys, just to open up a little bit more space in the middles there and allow them to then to release to the outside, because if their wingers are, you know, certainly renowned wingers, so they know how to get the ball now.
Yeah, absolutely. I think these games are so tight. It comes down to that any potential error rate and the composure, and we've got plenty of that in both teams, so really will come down to the wire. As we kick off into the second half, Tainui get the start. Looking to work through that middle, 3-3 Peel. Rip out to Opa Wingus, testing again. Got him that one. I think similar play they ran earlier on in the first half, just to test once again. So working with that wind to this right side of the field as we see it. Picked opens, a late. Will have gone forward even without the wind.
Great defense by Samoa there. Just holding, you know, not latching and going with it. Just holding. They knew what was coming with that cut.
Yeah, nice play. Nice quick play transition. Samoa, just got picked up. Joseph Green has picked up. Perhaps a little bit of a hold in that play. Holding up the Tainui players. So can't do that as you go into the ruck to dump the ball to. So Tainui will get another shot at it here. Coming in. Awa and Tumaya. E4 on the walk. Just loses a step. Perhaps checking. Was he onside?
I think he was checking to make sure that Joseph knew that they weren't getting back, so he was trying to expose something.
Yes. I was going to say, if not for that one, then later in the game, he'll always check and just make sure. Referee's just checking in. Yeah, happy with that play. There was potential of a penalty, questioned, but as we'll see on the replay, quick, really just got caught up, went off to the man on, which allowed the dummy half to split through, and E4 was able to just break away from his player and get the ball down. Good skill set to get that down nice and quick.
Yeah, Efo did well then, just at the ruck to make sure that he got right on the outside shoulder of his man, create plenty of space for himself.
Tainui continue to get that good, strong contact in the ruck. Samoa, as we saw with Tainui, looking to throw into that left side against the wind, with the wind. Tainui defuse it, looking to come out with energy, breaking through the middle. Transition players coming on, getting over the 10, looking to get to the strike. Where are they picking up from the 32? Yeah, just lost their shape a little bit there, going back to 32 other side. What option? Oh, he might have got away, did he? Ooh. That will look good on the replay. Almost broke his own ankles, I think, on that dancing on the touchline, dead ball line.
Yeah, Sonny Tedder with the touch there. And I thought he was back. Actually thought he had made the touch.
Beautiful. As we said at the start, it's going to come down to a little bit of composure, and that's excellent work there to get Tainui up one now. 5-4. Long time to go in the game, though, but it's going at pace. Samoa just checking, asking the defense to come forward. Chucking that 32 longer, Danyon, extras. Did he control it down in the corner? Yeah, referees are happy with that. Nice change up there from the 32 long platform. Do we get the replay? Yeah, here we are, KBS replay. George asking them to come forward. Gets them nice and high.
And this is the benefit of just out and out speed. Just Daniel Puturangi, just getting to the outside of his man, and you know, just a quick pass to Takoha. Takoha on out to the wing.
Sweep round. Yes, often we start to see that link defender will shoot up and hit off that 32 pass out ball, but he's sort of held in two minds there. As we come back, Tainui coming back, chucking out to Finn. Finn's going to try and keep it alive. Chucks a long ball himself, just shows you wingers need to be able to throw them as well, not just all the middles and the links.
Wind assisted, you reckon, Grant?
No, he'll call that. It was dead flat.
He'll call it all power.
100%.
Oh, just a little bit messy there for Samoa as they try and come through their transition. They need to pick up on this four touch, build a bit of momentum off this last one just to get them going forward.
Good platform, looking
nice
to work.
Nice feet.
That's the honesty in our game. Great touch made there, almost made his way through. Oh, little out ball. Good, got a fly coming in. Ooh. Finally on the charge here. Good platform, needs a strike off that. Just. Ooh, gets the call. Not sure that was it, a yes no potentially, or not moving forward?
Not moving forward, I think, Grant, on that one.
Running that same sweep, looking to get through. Good, nothing wrong with that on the first when you get a whole set in there. Have a dive rather than try and throw a 50-50 ball.
You can see the longs when they're throwing them into the wind, the ball. Wind's just holding that ball up just a little bit longer than it normally would.
Oh, plays short, gets the touch first though. Well picked up by Ray Kenzo, referee there, touch and pass, Samoa off the hook. Need to be clean coming out of here. Nice and controlled. Look to pick the pace up for a strike here. Coming back in. Still playing wind-wise, tip on.
Oh my goodness. Are they going to call that? Looks like they're going to give it, Grant. It's a good bit of skill there, tipping on.
Yes, look forward to seeing that one on the replay with this wind.
Tomatea Winiana. Nice release.
Ooh, too fast for the cameraman today.
Good reaction by the link there, just to tip it on.
We're back, no time's lost here. Tainui's right down on seven already. Samoa's been asked to move forward. Push high, both middles caught up. Little play on, says the ref.
Nice lift by Danny in there, yeah. Nice and high. Nice and early.
Whoa.
And in the lane.
Good lane. Not uncommon for Ramika to be in that lane. He plays down in Christchurch and many a time he's been in the lane against us. So see that many a times, but great pick out by Samoa. They get off the hook here. Looking to capitalise on this one. Perhaps stretch the lead out to two. The all-important two tries ahead. 5.5 minutes to go. Just looking to get the defence up.
Yeah, I don't know that Samoa's pick, that Tainui's only sending the one point up. It would be good to see them just try and shift the ball a little bit more to try and to pull two people up, but you know, points to Tainui for just being able to send that one up without without getting called on it.
Yeah, it comes back to that composure, doesn't it? They're nice and calm and nice and relaxed, and sometimes that allows them to just be set. Be good to see Samoa a little bit of ball play just to try and get both middles up or put some pressure on the referee to push that defensive line up and forward. They're getting the best of it down there as they come in. Nice strike, platform out the back. He's got him on the plus there. Nice play. Let's see that back on KBS replay. Good platform there. Picked.
Nice delivery out. Unfortunately, Nehana Mataafa just a little bit too tight there. Didn't release quite early enough out to his man, but nice option taken by Tainui. You think they may have practiced that some stage?
I think they've done that once or 1,000 times probably. Beautiful little extra play. We've seen a lot of really quick, well-timed sweeps. This one sweeps early. Defender just takes out too wide. And beautiful little play. Then come back on the inside. Very, very hard to defend in that space. As we see, same thing. E4, oh.
The pitcher, does he have the pace?
Finn's going
all the way. Finn Barnett trying to come across from the far side. That was a great bit of positioning there by the Samoan winger. Just stepped up into the lane on it. Snatched it out of the air.
Yeah, as you see, great. Managed to evade the desperate touch there. And then just stretches the legs out. Very, very hard to turn around and chase from there when you're attacking right on the line. Get Samoa up at 2-try lead. We've got 2:50 to go in this men's open semi-final at Pacific Cup touch.
Plenty of time to get some back here for Tainui. The man does it again. Just shows, holds, waits, and then pokes his head down through there. Nice bit of patience by him.
Yes, looks to freeze out George and stutter steps and everything and manages to get it down. So back in the hunt, Tainui make it count. They really need to stop this one from Samoa coming down. No doubt, just nice and composed here from Samoa, just looking to get down to the line. Ooh, a little bit of outplay. Ooh, did he get him on the back? Did he get him?
They'll have a little bit of a discussion about it, maybe.
A little bit now and a lot later, no doubt. Samoa eating up a bit of time around there. Looking to get out.
Just stretching, trying to lift up. He's around now. Oi!
So, oh, one to go. Referees have called.
Forward pass.
I was going to ask you if that went down, what sort of pass you thought that one might have been. I'm not sure that one's got a name just yet. But the fuse now, getting down 60 seconds. Plenty of time, Tainui, got to go down. Get one to stay in that hunt. It's been tight, we talked about this. No little indiscretions here. They need to get length of the field with some tempo now to get this strike. Got the platform they want. Oh, just on the scoop. Couldn't pick it up. Going to have to put some pressure on here now.
Now we get to see how Samoa's clock management is. Keeping it clean. Not doing anything rash. Just trying to get that touch three there. Coming through. Someone's going to have to get cracking on four shortly. 20 seconds to go.
Daniel will take that forward. Oh, just slipped a little. George on the ball, footwork. Replay. Possibly wanted to throw that long out. Tainui get a
nice
chance.
Nice lift there by the defense.
Right through, last bit of chance. Oh, flick pass.
Finn Barnett on the run.
Can't break through three. And there we go. Samoa. Stay composed to take this one out in the Open Men's semi-final. 8-7 over Ngā Tini o Tainui. Samoa will advance. We'll see them later on in the men's final at 4:20. Great game here. Stay with us. We'll wrap this one up. And then we'll be back at 3 o'clock Open Women's Final, Metro Māori versus Ngā Tini o Tainui. Stay tuned, we'll be there.